Mastering in Java Full Stack Technologies, and this is a complete guide. What are the tools and technologies required to master into Java Full Stack? As there is a growing demand for Java Full Stack, and these are highly paid professions. So there are front-end technologies, there are back-end technologies, and there is a database. So you need to have a good and sound knowledge of front-end technologies, back-end technologies, and the databases. So we need to understand actually what are the front-end technologies. So kon-kon se front-end technologies hai, right? React.js is a very popular framework. Angular is very popular framework, right? And basically front-end where you actually build this UI, right? User interface. User interface is nothing but that which you display on that what we can call as either on the mobile or maybe on the browser, correct? So these are much more popular framework, but these React.js and Angular built on top of the JavaScript and TypeScript. So JavaScript is base level of framework, right, for dynamic web pages, correct? And you use HTML elements and HTML tags to display that entire content, right? So you need to have a sound knowledge of HTML5 tags and HTML. To decorate this page, you need to have a good knowledge of a CSS, right? Cascaded style sheet. And there is a one particular framework, right? You will have heard about it. There are many such framework, right, for CSS. So you can go and check it. So TypeScript is one more framework which is built on top of the JavaScript, right? JavaScript ES6 concept, you need to have a good and sound knowledge like modules, then also for promises. Then there are many such other Java ES6 concept, arrow function like that. So this is all about the front end, but at the end, you need to have a sound knowledge of a React.js, either a React.js or Angular. Now we will come back to a backend technologies. So backend technologies, which we are talking about when we are talking about Java. So what are the framework we use it, which is built on top of the Java? So Quarkus and Kotlin is also a, you can say, some of that framework which is run on top of the Java when we are talking about building the RESTful APIs. Also, but most demanding framework which we are talking about, that is a Spring Boot, right? And some of the people are also using a Spring into legacy application, but Spring Boot is a much more demanding framework. So you need to have a sound knowledge of Spring Boot. So there are different components of a Spring Boot, how to develop the REST APIs and how you can build a different type of application. So there are different modules into a Spring AOP is another module, right? Spring MVC. Then there is also a Spring JDBC messaging, and there are many more. But at least you should have a sound knowledge of Spring Boot to a database integration with the help of JPA and Hibernate. So when we are talking about database integration, nobody is using a JDBC, but you need to have a good knowledge of JDBC, Java Database Connectivity. So JPA is basically using internally JDBC, correct? And Hibernate is framework which is using, we are using it. So JPA is a provider, correct? But Hibernate is nothing but that JPA is what we can say the specification. Hibernate is the implementation provider. So you need to have a sound knowledge of JPA and Hibernate also, correct? Because it's not like that every time you will just build the application into a Spring Boot and without connecting to database. 70-80% you need to have a good knowledge of database connectivity with the help of JPA and Hibernate. How to create a one-to-many relationship, how we are using the repository, how we are connecting, managing a transactions, and many more things like that, correct? Also, here, you need to have a good understanding of a microservice architecture, right? So microservices, you can build in Quarkus, in Kotlin, in Node.js, and many different applications and different technologies. But microservice architecture is also a little bit at high level. You need it whenever you are going much more deep inside it. Not for freshers, not for beginners, but after you can say you are mastering into full stack technologies, there is a next step for microservices. After that, there is a requirement of a database. Kyunki jo bhi aap perform karoge, you need to store these things into a databases, right? So there is a different databases, MySQL databases, right? There is a, you can say NoSQL databases and SQL databases, RDBMS databases. So Postgres, MySQL, SQL Server, Oracle, all these are nothing but RDBMS, relational databases, MongoDB, Cassandra, all these are NoSQL databases. So depends on the requirement, you need to use it. But bare minimum, you need to have a good understanding of RDBMS, right? And especially you need to have a basic knowledge of normalization also, correct? So this is what is the basic requirement for full stack technologies, right? And here you also, if you will go a little bit deep inside, there are many more tools like Kafka, Elasticsearch, GraphQL. So many such things are there. But at least if you will have one of the things you need to pick it up for React.js or Angular and from the front end, from the back end, you can pick one of that is the Spring Boot is much more demanding with Java. Then you need to have a good understanding of at least one of the databases with the SQL queries and RDBMS, either a Postgres or MySQL. So this will make that complete package of a full stack technologies, and you can give a good sound and interview when you are going for an any company, correct? Later, we will also talk about that, how you can use that full stack technologies with the, what we can call as cloud development and the cloud deployment. Apart from that, later also, you will need to add it many more technologies like Maven, and build tools. There is a Docker for containerization, but this is also we are talking about little later side, right? In the next stage. So there is a step-by-step process. So this is a complete understanding and where you can make your profile, right? As per the industry demand. I hope you got the point here, right? If you find out good things here in this particular tutorial, definitely you can provide some comments. Also, you need to tell me, right? What is the difference between React.js and the Angular, and which is you will prefer as part of the learning, right? Do you want to go with the React.js or do you want it to go with the Angular? So you can provide into a comments. Also, you can provide that which is the most favorable database. Do you want it to go with the MySQL or Postgres? So you can also suggest if you wanted to go with the Postgres, you can provide some pointers. If you want to go with the MySQL, you can provide some pointers. So thank you very much.